Good morning, guys. Today we're talking about the choice of cities. And this might sound like an odd idea to even question whether you should work with a city or not. But in my experience throughout running Urban Workshop, we've had many cities that we worked with or started working with while we really, really shouldn't have. Now, you might be in a situation in which you're applying for a grant, taking part in some sort of an open call, and your choice is which city to apply with, which city to choose to go to and discuss introducing an innovation, a new process into the way they are doing things while being funded from somewhere else, or even while using your own seed funding to create, to build the proof of concept. Now, not every city is ready for that. Not every city is best placed or at the best moment in time to actually start working on introducing innovations, look into transformation, and do all sorts of things that are actually disrupting the traditional way that things have been done in the city. So I've put together a list of three things, red flags, pointers, points of advice, if you will, that you might want to consider while choosing your city. The first one is the why. Why does the city, why would the city be interested in introducing an innovation or experimenting with any new tool? Now, the reasons during the first conversation might be the ones that you actually want to hear. We are ready, we recognize that this is the way forward, we have that in our development strategy, you name it. This is why you might want to have additional meetings and additional conversations about the entire process. Typically, when you work with innovations, the processes, the tools, the languages that you use are new to the old bureaucracies, which most of the cities, let's be honest, still are. This is why you might want to have several meetings with the leadership to establish what their motivation is, what is the core of their motivation to actually join forces with you, work with you towards a new solution or towards creating a new operating system for the city. This is because, and I must say, I've had some really, really painful experiences with that. This is because sometimes the motivation is not where it should be. And with social innovation, but I guess with many other things in life, there's nothing worse than doing the right thing for the wrong reasons. So make sure that you're not, for example, jumping into a moment in time when the city needs a quick win, when the city needs something to show, to present to either their own citizens, their own inhabitants, or to other cities or to the ministries, that they are not in dire need to present something, to showcase something that would present them in new light. Now, as you might know, with innovation, it takes time. It generates a lot of new situations, sometimes conflicts, sometimes points of frustration that might be difficult to handle if you're under pressure to deliver something shiny to whoever the audience for the city would be. Now, there's nothing wrong for the city to need to reestablish its position, show itself in a new light. That's perfectly fine. But if you want to introduce new systems, innovation, experimentation into an old system, you need time, you need space to breathe, you need some calm to actually go through the process in a responsible way. That is why you should really, really make sure that you understand the motivation of your municipal stakeholders and that it's all clear to both sides of the process. Now, number two, make sure you're talking to the right person. And I have experiences from both ends of the spectrum. I've talked with amazing leaders within municipalities who had the position, who had the standing to actually push forward whatever we were doing, to actually have the mayor's ear and be able to negotiate new procedures, new resources that would be necessary in order for us to progress. Now, I also have experiences of talking with some amazing public officials who understood the notions, who were really inspired and interested in bringing these new tools into the municipal system, but at the same time, they were in no place to actually push for the change. And so we spent months, if not years, discussing potential common projects, but not really moving ahead. So that's number two. And then number three is the resources. The main key, the vital resource that you might want to make sure that you have is time. Innovation, any sort of transformation, takes time, takes patience, takes perseverance, takes a lot of talking, lobbying, negotiating, digesting, working through things that are new to the system as it was. So you should not be under any pressure of time. You should look for a situation in which the city says, we have time to do it. We're not in a rush. We want to do it right. We can go step by step, and there are people in our team within the municipality who will be devoting enough time so that the process is complete. They will be not over-occupied with other things somewhere else. The other resource that you might want to look for is, of course, money. But in this context, what you are really, really looking for and what you're trying to establish while choosing your city is whether or not your project is a standalone or if it plays into other activities that the city is doing. And what I mean is that quite often, even though we enter the city with a project that is supposed to be transformational for the entire city, we end up finalizing it, going through it in a manner that in a way is standalone, and once we're done, there's nothing in the system that can sustain the living of the process, that can allow the municipality to actually scale up or multiply elements of the process that are really beneficial for the city. So you want to make sure that the that from the very beginning of the process, there's common understanding that in the end, what you're introducing as this sort of pilot, experiment, whatever you want to call it, is later on open to further implementation, that there are resources, both financial and structural, that will allow you to move ahead and to actually implement the new solution, if and when it's working, to other parts of the city. Now, these are the three key elements that you might want to check, double check and triple check, before you make an agreement with the city to move ahead. Because more often than not, there are innovations, there are new solutions that actually go well, that actually are implemented within the framework of any given project or process. They are done, everyone is happy with the results, and then it's game over. There's nobody or not enough resources to pick it up and diffuse or scale up whatever you established and worked out. I realize that the choice of a city is never easy. Very often you might want to go with your hunch. I've done it several times and it worked quite well. So if you have a sense that the city ticks off all of the boxes that I mentioned, and the enthusiasm and energy within the team that you're gonna be working with directly is there and is in the right place, just go ahead. I keep my fingers crossed for all of your new adventures with municipalities all over the world. If you have any other pointers that you think people should consider when choosing a city they work with, please let me know in the comments below. If any of the pointers and the red flags that I mentioned have been part of your experience, also share your stories so that others can learn not only from their own mistakes, but also from ours. In the meantime, take care, and I'll see you next week.